now we're moving to our last talk of the morning, given by Francesco Mauro. He's going to talk about the new photometric Python 3 package,
Sketchfile.
That one.
Yeah, the name is particular because it came from my nickname. SKZ is the abbreviation on the nickname. It's quite a long journey. Thank you for the talk. It's essentially little background because Virtual Observatory are definitely growing globally, just accumulating a lot of data, at least with Chilean, that also with the Virtual Observatory, they are all around the world, like for the ISO, or the Cerro Tololo, but also Chilean. We have 10% of the time of the telescope, so we can observe a lot. We are starting to have a lot of data. And usually, to do process photometrically, the data are not so straightforward. It's not so simple as usually it seems for a photometer, because you need to learn the detail of the program, all the steps you need to do. Sometimes can be quite can be easier. Some program needs want more steps, like Dowfot. You get a photometry stacking, the source list, the final photometry, put together the catalog. You need several acknowledgement times, and not always people want to have the opportunity to use 1 month to just understand how to do it. Usually, the classical idea to solve some problem was automation pipelines. So probably every photometer around the world has produced its own pipeline to process quickly the data. But generally, it should be quite really personal and focused. You are doing just for what you want to do, and maybe just connected to the specific data you are collecting. In my case, the project of the SKZ pipeline, both born during my master thesis, they gave me like 100 images from the Warsaw telescope. It was Ogle 3 sensor, if I remember. And doing a lot of iteration that Dowfot needs was too much time. So I started to write this code that can do all that this iteration by itself. Was quite advanced now, but the idea was was generic automate, but obviously it was not so really automatic. I saw that for me it was easy, but passing through a colleague, there was at least one question every day. How was this, how was that? So, okay, it was not so easy actually to use it. Essentially, it was also several scripts in Perl that was running external program, both Dowfot or program in C, because when more precision was needed. The next way to do it was the pipeline done for the survey, the VV SKZ pipeline. There was completely complete automation, but really focused. Was really nice because you have just to run it, just write a file saying take this paw print and want to extract this chip and so on. So doesn't need a lot of work, but was just for the VVV with its parameters and cannot. Not so easy to adapt to do something else. good solution, easier to use, but not to reuse. This was for my PhD thesis. Then I start to think how to produce something that was usable for other. And the first idea was to create a version of the VVVSPS pipeline for other instruments. But definitely, since it seems was quite problematic, and merge ideas, not always the result, you can have or the something that start to fighting with each other, and not really correlating with each other, or this famous case when you are merging just to have a result, but you are losing most of the things that was good. So I discharge it and start with another idea. Something was going to conference was sometimes really useful, because in Astroinformatics in Chile in 2015, George Jodorowsky said that in the area, probably the virtual observer will provide not raw data, but just the product of not mainly. So the idea that in the future, astronomers will just download the data they want and do something, then can do it automatically, it will be nice. Then last year also, Cale Posterer remember that non-biased system. Usually there is always this problem that you are thinking on your idea, on your way, and you are putting your bias because you find a nice way, it is really good, and if you they said that better the good way, but you change the data and screw up completely, because something that is really nice, something is working perfectly for a set of data, like doing the matching of the images with WCS for WVV data is perfect. But if you're going to JSOI, it doesn't produce a good result, simply because the Pisker scale is different. In with a little shift of 1 arc second, 1.1 second in the data is almost that you can see it. But in JSOI that you have 50 pixels or every arc second, and usually in crowded area, you start that you can have a match even if it's not a good the right match, because you have a lot of stars, so you can match thousands of stars anyway. So the idea was to create something that was helping the astronomers to help with the burden of the data elaboration. And at the end, I start from scratch, change a little the name, and also take advantage of the fundacy postdoctoral. I can dedicate several years to this project. Something was easier to use, and giving the perfect interface with the photometric program. Now it's a doubtful, but because I knew it, but can be, but with the idea that we added other program in the future. So the idea is that it was not too much doubtful based. Everything covering all the steps, and there are some steps that are sometimes not well considered, like the information collection that is really important. Can be an high level of generality in the command, and that you can use it to cover everything and you can do what you want. Then also was something was easy to use is also something that is easy to install. So the idea started with the directory with Python 3, because will be soon at the moment where Python 2 was the main, but Python 3 will be soon the new main version. And with the C extension, to try that is arrive the package, you just install a unit external program like was the VDV version of the Python. And using only module package Python was easy installable. So something that you not have to look for download, but you just when in a common Linux distribution, for example, they are already there, or like Anaconda. Essentially, is changing completely from doing what was previously a pipeline, something that are connected one after the other to an environment. You need to create something more complicated, more complex, and interconnected. That means also a structure more modular, with the several parts doing several enum action, and something that doing most other things, both of the command and functionality, essentially like Swiss Army knife, that you can everything to do something. And you need also to start to think of an abstraction or everything quite high, using a lot of classes, hierarchy, subclasses. Because if you want to use, for example, several files, several programs, you need that the program can interact between them. So they can use the output of the other. That means that you just not read a file of the output as it is, but you have to create something behind. A class can be a general file. So you have to abstract what is a file, how is it structured, and so on. Take quite a lot. This is an example of the general structure. There are the package with the several modules, actually sub-packages, to do what you need, part of with all the parameters, option, internal database, and the classes, a part with the general function, part for the matching, for the photometry, with the submodule for downvote to elaborate standards, and some module for the pipeline, because to give something also usable immediately for the starting. Like one step that is really important is the info collection. It is essentially in three phases. One is the list that of the data. You can have the images already there, or like for DV, you have the mosaic. You need to extract the image to elaborate. That is two different also way to elaborate, because if it's just the image, you have the vision image with all the data about the image, in which instead if you have a mosaic, you need need a different input to extract which chip or which area. Then there is a collection of information about each specific image, like can be inside the date of the observation, the instrument, other sub, like in VV, there is the zero point of the magnitude, the ellipticity, the filter, the status of the observation, ABC, so then the level. Only interesting information, and also information about the instrument, because you have the gain, the RON, the saturation level for each chip, and other that you have to obtain from website of the instrument, manuals, or what is the common knowledge. Something maybe is an article, or you retrieve calculating by itself, by yourself. This also needed to create a little easier the process, because I say the people don't want to lose time looking for the right command. So I want to just to extract the image and then obtaining the others, so I have to run this program instead of I have already the in the list of the images and I run to another. So there is an intelligent automation. There is in several function can do several part, but there is also a common in input data and initialize that simply take the input data, look at them, see how the structure, if the list are images or are mosaic, if there is information on that sort of kind, and decide what he has to do, if he extract the chip or other, then all run the process to extract images, the information from the header. There is an internal in the package database also with the parameters like cars of the to read from the headers, option for the photometry for which several that are particularly good for the instrument aliases, because we are talking about K-short passband, but not always inside the header it's written K-short or KS. Can be changed a little. JSOI have a little longer name. Sometimes you have a V filter, sometimes you have V Bessel filter, and so on. CTII, it is I, but with a little different name. So if you need to, for example, calibrate, you need to have a simple name, and there are some aliases to have a simple. Uniform the information. Then about other, there is a completely also manipulation of this input data, because you have in this way you create an internal database for every image with all information, but maybe you want to add some information to delete entries, because you don't want you just want to select images with a certain full width or certain area or something like that. For example, to extract from the mosaic, you just give the center of you are interested a radius, and the program automatically extract all the chip that will center fall inside of this part. So it's then all the other that permit to select, include some other tags, so other columns on the internal information for the image, and print it to use later. All these things is that need to little higher traction, use a lot of subclasses to elaborate, for example, start with the basic class of image. On this class, I construct another class, subclass that is the photo approach, that is the base for the photometric processing. Then prepare image of just some information. This one permit introduce other method to run internal processing. And for the single program, there is another subclass of the previous two that with all the methods to run every single aspect of the, in this case, the photo processing. Both the atomic part of the single program, like running the aperture photometry, the PSF, calculator of the PSF, the adding stars, subtract stars, something like that, what you need. And then also the more complete sequence to do every step of the photometric elaboration. Then I said, if you want to move to that different program can use the output from another, you needed to create subclasses also for the files. So generate a general file that are simply an idea, a header with a body, can be what else, that is then the photometric file that is thought to have a header and a list of sources, and also to understand how is structured form a photometric file. Essentially, is not only the header, not only the sources, but also its format of how it's written and the format of the sources, because different programs can have the same information, but this is written in different precision, in different ways. So to pass one file to another program, you have to translate in that way. Then it's also started to need it to do some multiprocessing that was introduced also recently, because when you are looking in the central part nearby the central galactic, or via some part that are like 300 epochs, so you need to run quickly. The multitasking for several most time consuming part are automail, the parallelization, and also is not blind to parallelization. It check if there is enough RAM to run it. So if you are saying, please use 7 core, it check if there is 7 core, and check if the RAM on the machine is enough to run 7 different process. For example, all frame needs a little more RAM than just running a PSF calculation. As I said, not just tube and fittings, but also pipes. There is a part for doing all the already pipelines. The basic user can use this directly. More advanced or picky user can do their own pipelines. And essentially, it's easier if you're using in Jupyter, that because it's really good in this case. And the code offer a lot of possibility for the matching. You can use the WCS internal program that like don't match, fixing value, and so on. Doing the stacking just vanilla all together, or splitting in sub-stacking like VVV, dividing by several OB, the JHK, the Z and Y, and the F and K in 3 different stack, then average them, or you can have one stack for every band and then merge together. This is also useful to have as a subproduct the deep stack for every filter. Lot of personalization, non-biased, so you and the user can do a lot and to submit to personalized. There is more than 150 options, actually 161 by now. You can do essentially set most of things. Also, there are something for debug, speed up. There are the possibility to skip something that sometimes maybe it's better to run the DAO master twice or three times. If you just put the speed up, depending on the level of speed up, you can just run one. Or you are saying if to avoid sometimes all stars get stuck, giving the time that all stars have maximum time they have to run for the period, then the package kill it and continue. Inherit the previous calculation, PSF, that is when doing the PSF calculation, check if it failed with some PSF function. It check for the stars, change the PSF function, and so on. Like was a little more advanced than the version. Feature, what want to do next is increase a little more the ability to be autonomous, so can change if there is something, if the, for example, the matching isn't really good, to check and continue adding more photometric software. We are considering the, for the first set of startup, a nice way also to find stars, and maybe possibility to include an integration with the software, with the software, because now the output has to be outside, but it's what the license. And additional product of all these years was also that we had to, with the permission of Setu, started to introduce the dynamic memory location in DAOFOT and introducing the BLAS LAPACK for matrix inversion, that is a little better, some bugs correction. Luckily, this is waiting 4 years that is waiting Stetson approval, because I send it to him the first time I came here to Hawaii for the General Assembly. Also change a little in the like in Montachu originally, since it was thought with not so much RAM, just to use the 13 best pixel. Now the default change to use all. That is better if you have like 300 epochs, why just use 13? Use the stack to be better. And also same problem with the PSF fitting, that sometimes the old star are fitting, but the star actually is moved around. So the program inside has a look for this shift and recorrect, reassigning the ID to the correct position, because the internally in the file, the stars, the sources are recognized not by position but by ID. And sometimes it was happened that a piece of star was disappearing suddenly. This is just because doing all star, it was assigned ID to another stars that was a bad one and was rejected. And thank you, especially for the fundus potatural sounds that the code will be released in general public license. And soon, I think now I'm almost finished, will be uploaded to GitHub, PIMP, PIP, and so on.
Thank you, Francesco. Any comment, question?
So I have a question. I mean, it seems like every project develops its own photometry pipeline. I mean, like it went with Glimpse, we had to develop our own pipeline because we were dealing with crowded fields. So the pipeline you're developing, is are crowded fields require different handling than sparse fields? I mean, how do you deal with the fact that, that your background may just be blended sources?
It start using the DAOFOT that is some manage, because with the stacking you can recognize a little better star, so you can go really little deeper than usual. And so we saw for the article DVD, as it said, the pipeline. Then we did a lot of job doing for the saturation limit, and since that all frame just not just fitting completely, if the star is saturated, it's just fit on the wings. So it's possible to recover also in the VV case at least two magnitude above the saturation limit. Mm-hmm. Usually the comparison with the true mass, it's good with the from K short 10 and fainter, it's quite good enough. It's when it is really crowded, it's not always so easy, but with the things we're doing, the stacking using the several, we are trying. I'm also trying that is an experimental part to recognize the saturated stars, the even saturated part that have this problem of destroying shape to tap, to fill this the hole. That some cases I found to work quite well, but I need to be quite sure that it's working before to put it completely.
Okay.
But usually it's worked quite well both in, as we saw in the article, the previous version, in the crowded with experiment with the M22, taking the inner part of the cluster and a little far away. And obviously when it's not crowded, managed to clean really well, except for the noise. Okay, you see some, especially in some part that you have the background is stars, it's not just sky, and the most crowded part sometimes manages, sometimes, especially when there are saturated stars, is more difficult because the shape of the stars are completely destroyed, so it's not easy for a program to recognize them as stars.
But I guess that the problem in the end is, the background program that we are using is Tau Photo, Tu Photo, whatever. So they are supposed to work in highly crowded fields.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how Tau Photo works with sparse fields. I can tell you that, you know, in order to have good results, for example, with Dufot, you need to have, like, I don't know, a given number of stars in order to calculate corrections in the magnitude, you know, because of positions in the image, because aperture corrections or this kind of stuff. So if you don't have enough stars, of course, maybe the best solution is probably use aperture photometry.
Yeah, so if you have really few stars, aperture photometry, fantastic, because you're just there.
You're done, yeah.
But you have